In this project tutorial, I'm going to show you all about how to customize your layouts like I alluded to in a previous tutorial. So we're going to dive in and we're going to take a quick look at it. All right, so now that we're inside ZOHO Projects over here, we have the ability to actually create our custom layouts. So you know when I was talking with you about, you know, how these task layouts look, things like that, all the different fields in here, we can actually make this look however we want, which is super cool. So in the top right, like any other ZOHO tool, you're going to see the setup section. Click on the setup and then come down to customization. You have the ability to customize your layouts and fields for your projects, your tasks, your timesheet, your issues, and your different milestones. So most importantly is actually going to be the tasks. So we're going to take a look at this one, but we can do the exact same thing with any of these. You can actually create a new layout, or you can copy and clone previous. You can edit other layouts that you have in here. So within the project, you can add in new fields that are important to you and to your processes. So if we come over to the tasks, we're going to create a layout. So we're going to create a new layout. This is going to be a, let's say, a roofing layout. So right now we have, you know, work hours. Let's say we don't need work hours, so we're going to disassociate that one. We want the status, the completion date, start date, due date, duration. I think we have to keep that one in there. Priority, we can keep that one in there. Completion percentage, rate per hour, we don't really need that one, but it looks like we have to keep that one. Unfortunately, it is a standard field, so some of these we can and some of these we can't. Budget, we have to keep that one as well. Billing type, we can get rid of this one, so we're going to throw that over there. Budget, we have to keep all those, budget threshold, revenue budget, and cost per hour. So these ones we do have to keep for ZOHO Projects back end reporting aspect of it. We can't remove any of these. However, what we can do is we can actually add a section in here and say unimportant fields. Let's just put that. So we're going to remove this from, remove these from that section. So budget threshold, tags, completion percentage. I want to keep the duration we don't need in there. So these are maybe our more important fields up here, but maybe there's other things we want to add. Maybe we want to add a single line field, and let's say homeowner. We're going to call this one home owner name. Maybe we want to add in a ZOHO CRM ID so we can run some custom functions on all of this as well. So we can include any number of fields we want in here. We can actually add in formula fields, URL fields, emails, things like that. If we do want to keep track of anything, you can build in checkboxes. So if you have priority, let's say that, you know, for your takeoff task, you want to make sure that you have the ability to have the checkboxes, and you want your team, your crew leader, to check off all the different checkboxes as you're completing these items. So you do have the ability to come in here and add in any fields you want to customize it. So a few other things is maybe you want to choose a crew. So a user pick list, maybe you want to put it in here. You want to say this is, so this is a pick list field. So we're going to say crew assign and select users. So user pick list values is you can select different people that you want to select roles. So different roles that you can choose. Now roles are another type of customization you can have. So you could have, administrator, let's say crew leader, you could have techs, things like that within here, so they can have access to that. In this case, that is not super helpful. So we maybe actually want more of a select, just a regular pick list, not a user pick list, because that allows you to choose a user in the system. So we're gonna say crew assign, and we're going to add pick list values. So I'm going to say crew A, I'm going to add value. Crew B, I'm going to add that value in there. Crew C. So maybe you have a bunch of different crews that you want to assign to a specific project. So we have that. We're going to add that to the layout. So crew assign is now going to be a field. Anytime we go and create a new task, you're gonna see these, the homeowner name and the crew assigned. So I'm gonna save this layout. We're quickly gonna take a look at this and what this looks like if we go back to our Smith residence project over here. So I'm gonna create a new task. Now I'm gonna create a new task from a different screen that you may not be familiar with. So I'm gonna add a task here. So I am going to add a new task and I'm going to say, let's say roof takeoff. So I'm going to add that in here. We need to remove the old roof. Now I know this is a rather quick process in general, but just to show you what it looks like, we do have, we're still looking at the old layout. However, we do have the ability, which is kind of cool, to change the layout itself. So we now also have to assign it. So what I actually forgot to do was I forgot to reassign the project to that new layout. So if I come back in here, I'm gonna go to the customization again, go to the tasks, and right now you see that the standard layout is associated with this Explore ZOHO Projects and the Smith Residence. Well, I'm gonna add a new project to this. So I'm gonna add the Smith Residence here. And now the Smith Residence is under this new roofing layout, whereas the standard layout, now that's disappeared. So if I come back to the Smith Residence, I'm gonna create new, and now we're currently under the roof, the replace roof task list. Looks like I made an error in there that I did not see earlier. And we have the tasks or the fields that are now custom. So the homeowner name. So we're gonna say John Smith. And the crew assigned, well, we're gonna assign crew A to this one. So now we can create a new task that is complete roof takeoff. And we are going to, we're basically just going to leave this blank. It's pretty self-explanatory. You can also create teams. So your associated team could be crew A, crew B, crew C, crew D, etc. So that could be another area that you can do that. The owner is going to be the crew leader. Start date is going to be, let's say, on the 20. Actually, you know what? Let's, because we, our date actually isn't until February. Let's say that we're going to start on the Monday, and we're going to say that February 6th, everything's going to be completed. And we can call this one a, let's just say hi as well. This has to be done before anything else can be done. Now we have the reminders of occurrences if we want to use those, the homeowner name, and we've labeled as John Smith and the crew assigned as crew A. So that allows us to add in a new task here that needs to be completed. And we have the unimportant fields here as well if you did want to ever take a look at those. So that is where that section shows up. It did not show up. If you can remember, it did not actually, if you can remember, it didn't actually show up on the initial task creation screen. So there is no unimportant tasks here, which is kind of cool. So that is all for this tutorial. This is really just showing you how to utilize ZOHO Projects more effectively so you can supercharge your systems and understand a little bit more about how you can maximize your project manager's potential and make sure that your customers are getting serviced the way that they deserve to be serviced. That's it for this tutorial. Please make sure that you are liking this video down below and commenting anything down below. I want to hear it all, good, bad, anything in between. Please let me know what you think of these tutorials in the comments. And if you have enjoyed and got any value out of this, please make sure you're subscribing so we can reach a larger audience like yourself and help more people understand how they can set their business up for success. That's it for this one. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.